Normally, we just bring broadcasters in here, TV, radio, internet people, that sort of thing. But I thought this was smart of us to bring a community activist in who is actually making a difference. And the reason why I wanted to bring him in is because so that you all would say to yourself, you know what, I could do something like that. In other words, I know you're on the radio portion of things right now, but you will be going on the TV. And just so you know, on the radio portion, by the way, you already have a radio station that will take your stuff if you're interested, and that's Chris Radio. You can do up to a 15-minute show, literally a pod, you know, podcast that they will take and they'll play. And Chris Radio basically services the blind, but you can get it, frankly, on any FM station here in Chicago. I mean, any FM radio, you can tune it in. So the gentleman who runs Chris Radio is more than willing to take your material. So if you had an issue that was of significance and you wanted to do it strictly as a radio and have to bring somebody in and interview, maybe a community leader or whatever, you know, or even interview somebody like Anthony talking about what he's doing, you could do it for radio. Now, the nice thing about what Anthony has done is he's come together, brought a team together of people, and he's dealt with one of the most nefarious topics when it comes to Chicago and living in Chicago, and that would be, what do you think it is?
Violence.
Gang violence, violence, period, violence. Why do we have a city in which 22 or 23 people are shot on a weekend? I don't know about you, but when I was growing up in Chicago, maybe someone got shot maybe once a month, maybe twice a month, whatever, on a weekend. You never heard of 22 or 23 people getting shot on a weekend. And that occurred with regularity throughout the summer, not only the last summer, but the summer before that. And it's got to a point where it's ridiculous. I mean, really, think about it. 22, 23 people in a civilized city the size of Chicago getting shot? I mean, that's ridiculous. So we've had students before who have said, I want to do something about it, but they really never have. So I wanted to bring somebody in who actually, Anthony, is doing something about it, and he's going to maybe play a video for you so that you can see what they're doing and talk about the bringing people together to make a difference. And so with that, let's welcome Anthony to ICB.
I do want to thank you guys for, you know, taking the time out to actually check out my presentation and, you know, hear what I got to say, because it is a positive movement that I am trying to build in Chicago. Like he was saying, it's a lot of shootings that's going on that's senseless, and with the way that it's increasing, you know, I didn't want it to come close to home, so I decided to step out on faith and take a chance and create something that most people won't do, and that's a voice that's going against, you know, the normal. Right now, shootings are a hot topic in our city, and I hate that it's actually, you know, is making our city more depreciative. Right now, we have one of the three largest cities in the world, but right now, all we hear about is the shootings that's going on and the violence. We no longer hear about how beautiful our downtown skyline is or anything like that. So what I wanted to do was try to create balance for the city and for the world. I know that people like to tend to reach to YouTube, World Star, anything viral on the internet, and most of the times things that's viral are negative or anything revolving positive, promoting violence. So in 2011, I came up with an idea to try to create something entertaining yet positive. That way the young people, the youth, and everyone would be interested in actually spreading the message and supporting something positive. I know how hard and difficult it is to get some positive in people's ears and continuously drain their minds with positive messages. So my whole intention was to create something entertaining. In 2011, I created my first short film, and I do want to reintroduce myself. My name again is Anthony Sturdivant. I'm an independent screenwriter, a filmmaker and producer. I'm self-educated. I taught myself how to do this in 2011 when I did my first film. It's 2014, and some of the accolades, I've been on WCIU, WGCI, NBC, I mean, the list goes on, Channel 11, WTTW, all this within 2 years of self-education. So anything is possible. I like to tell the youth that you can control your success. So in 2011, I created my first Think Before You Shoot short film, which is a short film series that's not intentionally preaching down on individuals, telling individuals that they're wrong, or what they're doing with their lifestyle is ill-fouled, but instead to promote positive and to embrace the importance of thinking before you act, react, and in any situation. A lot of shootings are due to retaliation, heat of the moment, or things of that nature, in which all we had to do was take a split second or a day or two to think about it, and you know, we could have relived or did the situation a little differently than most. What I will do is get to the first film. That way you can see exactly what I was getting at with the short film series. And the first one was more of a trial. Again, I am self-educated. This was the first short film I ever written, and first idea, concept, everything like that.
Situations.
But this is all I know.
But this ain't all you're required to learn. Just think.
Man, what's happening? Ain't got no money, no job, and my best friend just got killed. So the next person pulling with me, I'm pulling the trigger. Point blank, period.
Yeah, I appreciate that. So with the first one, again, it was more like a trial. My first time ever writing anything or even being involved with films. And this was in 2011. My first one, I actually reached out to a lot of people, just sending the link out to see who would be accepted for what it is and see what I'm trying to get at. And Tom Skillen of WGN, the meteorologist, was the first one to actually send me a message. He wrote on my Facebook wall at least two paragraphs about how he liked what I was doing, he liked the message in general. And ever since then, he's been a supporter of and been watching every film since. So that's what let me know that it was ready to be accepted. Considering the fact that he's someone not in the field or in the area that we're being affected by, yet he can understand what I'm coming from and be ready to support it. So that let me know that it's not just for my generation or the generation after me or my race or my neighborhood, but for the world to accept. And that's what motivated me to continue on with it. As you can see in the first one, the storyline behind it, I pretty much wanted to show perspectives of everyone in the facility or in the area of that situation. As you can see, you had one guy who was innocent talking about getting a degree and changing the world. Yet on the other side, you had someone who was frustrated with life. You know, father, friend just got killed. You know, and granted, I wanted to show how small things can be major to some people. So even in the line, he mentioned it's hot outside. I mean, and it might sound crazy, but a lot of people be affected by the heat and they get frustrated with life. They just don't know how to act or handle the situations. So I like to talk to the youth about that in general, like make sure you know how to handle life, because it throws different bullets and different things at you and that you're not ready for. So it's a certain way that in way you handle things. And I just wanted to show that in that film. Also, you noticed in the first one, he pulled out the gun in the first situation. The second one, he waited. He thought about it. And he ended up meeting and noticing that this is the guy who can help his nephew or his godson be successful. So I want the youth to understand, you never know who you bump into in life. So you got to know how to handle things. So it's always about how do you handle situations. There he goes. He's just bumped into someone who could change the life of someone that really matters to him. Yet, he had a chance to actually pull the trigger and take that guy's life based off, you know, misconsumption. So, you know, I like to give multiple messages within one film. That way I could talk to the youth and let them challenge me as well. Because of what I want to do is let them know that there are different ways you can handle situations. So, again, that was really my first film I've ever tried. So, you know, and I really just wanted to be an innovator. Life is about innovation. There's nothing new under the sun, so I will tell you that. But you can be as creative as you want because creative writing has no limits. And I see that you are into broadcasting and radio, so you can control your content. So my best, I just like to tell people to be as creative as possible. Find out what's been done, what hasn't, and, you know, combine it together to create something new. What I will do is go to the next film for you. With this film, just a little background behind it, I won a Prestige Film Award. Again, first time ever doing this, first time ever winning an award within my first film. WGCI called 30 minutes later, WCIU. So this film really set the standard for me as far as to know that this is what I want to do. I'll get right to it for you guys. See the license plate?
Yeah,
out of here.
First off, thank you before you shut up.
The film you just saw, what I liked about it, and this is coming from a guy in the Directors Guild of America, okay, with a lot of experience, but what I liked about what Anthony did, and his crew for that matter, was how they gave you everyone's perspective. Mm-hmm. The moms, I'm assuming that's a brother or a friend who's leaving. Even the young boy is sort of...
Because he would have been an innocent bastard.
Right. Would have been an innocent bastard. I mean, he's totally... And then you've got the other two individuals. And you see, and you're seeing the film from everybody's perspective. And what's so creative about it, too, is the editing in terms of the movement,
that.
The slowdown, the... Right. I mean, it's just, there's, you know... So this is all stuff that you can do. It's all stuff that you have the tools and the capability and that you'll learn here that you can do. But again, it's a terrific piece of work because, you know, there's not a lot of special effects. There's a few, obviously, with the gun and the...
Was that a real gun?
No.
Yeah. But I mean, with the yellow blast or the...
Yeah, you know, the fire.
So the fire of it. But it's so engaging. It pulls you in. You can't help but watch it. Yes.
I got something I want to say. Honestly, I think this whole idea is, like, really creative. You know, like, first off, I want to say, like, it's like, you know, they don't expect a lot of young black males to, you know, actually go and think of something like this. Mm-hmm. So I want to congratulate on that. Like, that's dope. Like,
thanks.
You know, like, it is. It really is, man. Like, not too many people, especially coming from or living in a city or being, you know what I'm saying, in a city or whatever the case may be, you know, like, I think it's sending a great message to the youth and even to some of the people, some of the cats that could be our age, you know, like, man, like, okay, well, if he, I don't know your background or your life or whatever the case may be, but if you were ever involved in anything, you know what I'm saying, they like, well, if he can do this, you know what I'm saying, he came from this, and then he turned around like this, then maybe we should, you know, like, it's sending a great message, y'all.
Yeah. And that's actually what I, again, when you find your purpose, you got to run with it. I always felt like people were intrigued by the way that I presented myself even before I got into all this. So what I wanted to do was present my, make myself a public figure so that the youth will want to listen to me. I know they grow up listening to music. They look up to people they don't know or that they see at a certain level of success. So I dedicated myself to be to reach that level of success just so I could speak with them. Again, I just want to lead by example. Like you were saying, people don't know my background, but what I will tell them is I didn't graduate. I didn't go to school to study none of this. It's all self-educated. Like, I just woke up one day, started writing, sending it to everybody I knew on Facebook. I was writing poems with stories, anything you name. I was writing commercials. I was just writing ideas, sending it to everybody I knew. And 100% came back with dope, creative. I love this. So that's what let me know that this is what I wanted to do. And
it's clear you're passionate about it.
Oh, of course. And that's what I was going to say. Even with the second film, I know you've seen a change of production. You got to invest in yourself. The first one I did, I had casted people, but as you've seen, I had to act in it. No one believed in what I was doing. No one understood what I was trying to do. So the people I casted didn't show up the morning of the shoot. So I had to jump in myself. I don't act, but I knew this is what I wanted to do. So I had to do it. And then the second one, I had to invest money just because I wanted the production value to grow so people can want to watch it. You know, I want everyone to want to watch it, even Hollywood. Like, it's not just for Chicago, it's for everyone. So I wanted to show that, even with my editor, you know, and that's big, you know, appreciation to my editor and my director, Leon.com. He's great at being animated, you know, as you can see from the license plates, the gun, I mean, the whole look of it. So I wanted to invest in that. I invested in an Emmy Award winning cinematographer to shoot it. You know, it wasn't cheap, it wasn't easy, but it was something that's needed in order for me to continue to gain and grow in the industry that I want to get in. And even with the messages, like, you know, I like to point out every message. If you notice, the guy got back in the car, said the gun jammed. Like to tell the kids, you know, don't let anyone peer pressure you. Obviously, he's lying just to keep cool points. He could have just easily said, I didn't want to shoot. I thought about it. I didn't want to hit anyone. But instead, he got back in the car and said a gun jam. Also, I like to preach the retaliation. Again, be an innovator. Think on ways that you can make people want to watch or listen to you again and again, because that's the key. The key is to continue to get those supporters to support you. Don't worry about the people who tune in once every blue moon. It's about the daily supporters. So I wanted to give messages to where they have to watch it more than once. If you've seen, the guy had his hand wrapped, the guy had the black eye, retaliation. A lot of people, you know, do shootings or retaliate with gun violence over something that was ill-fouled that from the, you know, from the beginning. So it was all about retaliation. And then again, like I say, as far as the different perspectives in the first one, I know you noticed that there was a lot of dialogue in the first one. So again, I wanted to grow the message, so I took out the dialogue so that people wouldn't want to argue or fight me with, oh, I wouldn't have said that, or that wouldn't have went like that.
But the reason why it's even more effective is because of the fact that there is
no dialogue.
When you're doing a film, okay, you want as least amount of dialogue as possible. I'll tell you a great film if you get a chance. It's called All Is Lost. It stars Robert Redford. You watch that film, and there's basically one word said in it, and it's the F word when he's upset. But any language would understand that he's upset. Mm. There is a little narration at the top, but then once you get into the picture, it's all visual.
That's just like Castaway for a long time in
right.
that movie.
Mm-hmm. Right.
It wasn't no talk for real. It's like he went around doing, it's basically showing scene from scene of him being lost on the island. Right. So
What was great about that film is it's the music, it's the editing, it's the perspective, and frankly, it is the fact that there's no dialogue.
Mm-hmm.
It is so much better than the first one.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he really has grown light years from that first one to the second one. You had a question.
Oh, I actually just want to say keep doing what you're doing, because I feel like a lot of people have that mentality or want mm-hmm. to say what you're saying but don't know how.
Yeah.
Be that voice, because I like what you're doing.
I appreciate it. You had something
to say.
I was just going to say that was shot beautifully.
Appreciate it, man.
And you want to know it, you could tell that it was very well written, too, mm-hmm. because nobody knows what to shoot if it's not written down on paper,
yeah.
You know what I mean?
But yeah.
That was
what did they
I appreciate
shoot
it.
That list, you know?
It was a Canon 5D.
Okay.
So that's better than... The filming wise, better than some underground movies I done seen.
Yeah,
yeah.
Way better.
I've got, and that's how the second one actually took me to the next level. It shocked people more. That's more so than anything. Like they saw the first one, then they seen the second one that quick, for it to look like that. And the first thing everyone says, it looked like a Transformers movie, or it looked like this and it looked like that. And it's like when you have a passion for something, you know, you want it to be as great as possible. You know, that's why I say don't let the money be your motive, because you'll end up doing stuff you don't want to do. You'll half do it. You know, it won't be there. You know, so find what you're passionate about and let success be your motivation.
Speaking of money, I'm just gonna ask: Are you able to get any kind of grants for any?
Not yet. I've been self-funded. Okay. Yeah, so far self-funded. Okay.
But I think this is the kind of thing that will eventually.
Yeah.
We'll get a grant for that.
I just try to preach a lot of patience, because. You know, you hear that a lot. Oh, you know, man, you know, congrats on the success or what's to come. And it's like, you know, I don't want people to think like it's just going to come. So got to put a lot of work towards it. So it's just really patience. I know what's expected out of this. And again, it's not money. That's why I turned it into a nonprofit. I feel like I got plenty of ways to make money. We all gifted. Money is already made. It's just you going to get it. So the money is nothing I'm really worried about.
So I'm going to challenge all of you, because there are plenty of issues that possibly, you know, you're passionate about and that you think, frankly, you know, there's something amiss or something not quite right. And that's why I'm going to challenge you to think about that, not only for television, but also for radio, and consider, you know, coming up with concepts, you know, that we, first off, we could air something on Chris Radio if you wanted to.
I want
to
join the movement with you.
We could talk about that.
And you can talk about that with Andy. And then just the thought of, you know, you know, actually producing something for television. And if you're not there yet, you can at least write it, and you can work with somebody in the school that is. So, those are the things I wanted to. That's the reason why we wanted to bring Anthony in today, because Anthony's self-taught. okay, you're going to school, you're going to a curriculum, you're getting an education, but he's self-taught. And but more important than that is he's on a mission, and what he's doing is important. It's putting out a message, which is, you know, let's stop the violence. Let's mm-hmm. stop all this gun violence. So, and we really need that here in Chicago.
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, we really do. Go ahead.
I was wondering, like, can you, we can share these videos, right?
Because of course.
Before you leave, can you write down the website and
of course.
Like that, so we can share? Because this is a message
yeah.
for everyone. So I think it would
yeah.
be nice to share these.
Of course, and it's open for, like she was saying, she wanted to be a part, it's open for that. By it being a nonprofit and me creating it to be entertainment with films and everything, I mean, it's opened the door for radio. Like, I even have a new segment that I created. And again, I'm all about being creative. Like, they say there's nothing new under the sun, but a lot of people, it's a lot of ideas out here that just are ideas. People don't act on them. So to me, they're not owned by that person. So. Even if it's an idea that you came up with and you felt like, someone felt like, oh, I had that idea before, doesn't mean anything. So I even created a news segment called Think Before You Shoot News that I have. And I wrote out who I wanted to get, reported on, who I wanted as a reporter. And now I have my own news segment. Who said I had to work for Channel 5 News? Who said I had to work for Channel 9? Go ahead.
So you're a writer too?
Oh, that's all I do. And that's why I was going to ask you guys, as dealing with broadcast, do you write?
I'm a writer.
So you do write? All right, because creative writing is the best thing that can be offered to you as freedom. You can write about anything, you can have your segment about anything. I mean, you could do anything you want when it comes to creative writing. And it's not just about acting, scripts, poems. I mean, you could write out a whole business plan and it'd be creative writing. It's just about acting on it. Writing it down is acting on it. A lot of people talk ideas, that gets you nowhere. You could talk about ideas forever. But once you write it down, that's letting you know that this is what you want to act on.
Here's
then you can plan it out.
Here's the website, tbys.wordpress.
It's a 4.
Huh?
TB4.
TB4YS,
I'm sorry.
TB4YS.wordpress.com. WordPress is something you're going to be learning.
Mm-hmm.
So,
and I have an official website, but it's being reconstructed right now, due to the new media attention, everything like that. I just wanted to upgrade it. So the official website is tb4ys.com, but it's right now just under construction. I mean, it still has the films and stuff on there, but it'll be back up. Like this, the blog site has everything from images, from school visits, news articles, pretty much everything that I've been dealing with for the last 2 years. And like I stress this a lot only because I feel like more people should do this. Please control your success, seriously. You can really do anything you want in today's age with the internet, free marketing, free networking. So nothing should be able to stop you from being successful.
And for those of you who want to talk to Anthony, we're going to conclude this, wrap this up, unless anybody has a question.
Can we see
We'll see another one, and... For those of you who want to get involved, I'm sure you'll stick around for a few minutes.
Course.
You can talk to Anthony. And what I like about what Anthony's done here, he's actually done something about it. Instead of saying, there's nothing I can do. And I've heard that from people so many times over and over. Well, just what can I do about it? There's nothing I can do about it. I'm stuck here. I'm where I'm at. This is where, there's nothing I can do. So. No, that's a pathetic attitude. Don't take that attitude. Take the attitude, I can make a difference. I can change something. He's doing it. You know, he could have done it. He could have taken the same tack. We'll just have to live with this. There's nothing. He didn't do that. He said, there's something I can do about it, and he's doing something. So go ahead, play it on,
right.
Please.
And I'm gonna get back to what he's speaking on with that one. I actually wrote one about that, actually. But this the third one.
She's just a girl and she's on fire. Higher than a fantasy. When you look a highway, she's living in a world and it's on fire. Dealing with catastrophe. But she knows she can find a way. Oh, she got both feet on the ground. And she's burning it down.
that supposed to be like that?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. keep the eye attention.
Okay.
With the third one, just to get right into it, I wrote this one around the time of the holiday, last Christmas. The wish list was actually a Christmas list, but I didn't want it to be dated. I didn't want people to feel like it was only for something to watch during Christmas. So I turned it into a wish list. And what I was getting at with that one is, I know a lot of people are putting pressure on themselves to take care of, you know, their child or anything materialistic. And I just wanted to show them that you don't have to go and take from someone, or your plan on taking from someone just to provide material things can go south. He might have thought, maybe I could go, you know, rob someone, get a few gifts, dollars, whatever it may be. I could go take care of my daughter. But in the midst of it, he's actually harming another innocent man's daughter. And I actually wrote it during the time, I don't know if you heard of Nas' song, Daughters. Yeah, so I actually wrote it during the time I was a fan of that song. So I felt like I could, you know, should stress the importance of daughters. And if you notice, it was two fathers in it. I read, you know, that's kind of rare. So again, as a writer, or being someone that's in control of your thoughts or your project, make sure you do things that's rare, limited, or, you know, something that will make the message stand out. Small things like that matter. I could have easily put a mother in there and it could have kind of offset it. I just wanted to show two daughters being taken care of by the fathers. One feel like he's pressured to take care of and provide for his daughter with something that he don't have. The other's actually doing that. You know, he's taking care of his daughter, providing, doing what it takes. Yet someone, you know, creeped in his backyard and possibly could have taken his daughter's life. Also, something small that you may not have noticed. During the pause and showing of the slow motion, it showed just the grass and the empty field. Even when he left, it just showed how quiet the neighborhood was. Usually what goes on in real life. You never know who's in the backyard getting robbed, in the house getting murdered, or right up the corner getting shot. You know, everything seems so normal and stuff like that. So I wanted to point that all out as well. As a writer, again, you have to be very detailed, especially when you only have 4 minutes to work with it. Little dialogue. So I just really wanted to, again, I like to point out more than several, two or three messages within the film, just to, you know, gain the attention of the viewers and the youth.